Marvellous Christmas. You can see where they like Maggie Thatcher. If Maggie Thatcher can come down to our community and see what we have done this Christmas, she'll never beat us as a community.
Okay, sure.
People don't understand what can happen when a pitch hit, but we know. Since the strike started, we've had no coal delivered at all, and we've been riddling to get extra stock in. It's coal has been over there 30, 40, perhaps 50 years. More or less rubbish. We're using it, but Maureen's able, my wife, to be able to do the washing and stuff like that. We got no other way of eating the house. We know in South Wales that if we lose this fight, is that it's the end of South Wales as a mining community. They say we lose money. Yeah, we lose money because the investment is not put into South Wales. We've got 15, 25 years reserves in Penrhiwceiber Colliery. We produce coal if we're allowed to.
When they come out on strike for wages, I do not believe in it. When they mention pit closures, well, I said, I'll stand by the side of you all the way. Because I did believe in this strike.
The issue of the strike, as far as I'm concerned, is that we're fighting to keep our communities together, and we're fighting for jobs for ourselves and our youngsters coming behind us. And that is the old issue.
Well, it's a different village altogether now. I mean, a 12-month ago, it was an old-fashioned village. Our parents had brought us up, and they were old-fashioned. A woman couldn't walk into a pub. You didn't have certain people speaking to you because they were a bit higher classed. But today, the community is together. The men and women are working together. They are willing to fight together, and I think we're alive now.
Since I've been on strike, I can do jobs now and do things in the house which I would never have thought of doing before. I'll do the washing. I'll put the over. I can do a dinner now.
I am enclosing a cheque for £12. £10 is from my son and is from myself, and £2 from my sister, who is a pensioner. Maybe it will provide some sweets for the children, or use it in whatever way you may think best. I haven't got my glasses.
You're handy, Pat.
We wish it was more. We have the greatest admiration for the stand you are taking and for the courage it must take to suffer the hardship and abuse. We feel you are all carrying the banner, not only for the NUM, but for the whole trade union movement. Our best wishes to you all for a happy Christmas, and as happy a Christmas as possible, and good luck and better times in 1985. Very sincerely, Mrs. Mabel First, that's the name. And she also sent me a book of stamps for my Christmas.
Oh, yeah, that was very nice. Now, there's a couple of new ties that the Women's Support Group bought, right, that we haven't used. So any of you who wants to buy them back, and the money go back into the Women's Support Group, you can buy them for the same price as what we paid for them.
How much? Well, 50 pence on it.
Yeah. Fire chief. 50 pence.
Go on, I love that. No,
more than one, I'm sorry. No? I love that for my granddaughter.
Many thanks and a Merry Christmas from Judith and John Lloyd and family. Hey. Nice to have a little bit of appreciation like that.
Yeah. Oh, that's lovely.
We went to Dover. There was a big march in Dover. The banners of the were lesbians and gays support the miners. And there was one big red satin banner. Oh, it was beautiful. Black people support the miners. My goose pimples when I read that, to be honest with you. That was really great.
Short and sweet meeting today.
Oh, if everybody can bring an extra carrier bag tomorrow. Will you fetch him now? Save us buying him. No, why I said was, in your parcel tomorrow will be two tins of beans, a tin of tomatoes and a tin of carrots. Then you go up the table, you get 2 pounds of sugar. You go in the next room, you get a jar of pickles, beetroot, panion, red cabbage, box of mince pies and a packet of biscuits. We get the food in on a Sunday, as me and my husband are on point duty all day on a Sunday. That's every Sunday from Bristol. Then on a Monday, we go up under the hall where they deliver it, and we take out perishables and things like that. We stack the tomatoes, the beans, the corned beef, and do all the stacking in the kitchen. There was another chap come in. I don't come up for a parcel. In fact, he said, I'm not short. So I just looked at him. I thought, no, keep it cool now. So I said, what are you doing here there? Well, I was told I can come up for toys. He said, for the two kiddies I got. He said, I got a part business, mind. But if you've got a part business, buy your own toys. Because we are here to give the needy, not the greedy.
You who have dreams, if you ask, they will come true. Would you turn your dreams to a fact? It's up to you. If you have the soul and the spirit, never fear if you see it through. Hearts can inspire other hearts.
give you 10,000 more. Shoulder to shoulder, and bolder and bolder, they grow as they go to the fore. Then there's nothing in the world can halt or mar a plan. When stout-hearted men can stick together, man to man. Give me some bread, with the stout hearts in men, in the fight for the right.
In the furnace I planted, sir, there are 750 men working. They've been 100% solid till now, and they've got one man and gone back to work. We are like one big family together in Penrhiwceiber now, because 75% of us are all in the same position. They've all got somebody that's affected by this strike, and so we've got the spirit in Penrhiwceiber now is, well, it's like it was during the war then.
We've been at the point of air. We left you 11 in the night. We got out of the bus at 20 past 5 in the point of air, straight on the picket line. The police come there, cordoned us off. So they shouted, Barbara, we want to go to the toilet. So I went, called this inspector, flat cap, they call him. So I called him over. I said, the girls want to go to the toilet, please. You're not moving from there. All right, fair enough, girls, I said, get on the road and pull your drawers down. Oh, don't do that, for God's sake, he said, you women are more trouble than men. Well, I said, they want to go to the toilet. They can go two by two. I said, they were in the bloody zoo two by two. We're not animals. You've got to be on the picket line to see what's going on. What you see on the telly is nothing. What you read in the papers is nothing. Because I never thought I'd be standing in 1984 on a picket line against I don't know how many thousands of police, because I was brought up to respect police. I don't respect them now.
Employers haven't come along and said, lads, you can have a fortnight's holiday. They've always had to be fought for. So the union to us means everything. The lives that were lost and the private owners then. In fact, in this pit alone, the number of men that were killed prior nationalisation runs into hundreds. And at that particular stage in time, if a man got killed, there was some sort of mild inquiry, and he was stretchered out of his pit, carried by his workmates up to his house. If an horse got killed, an horse on the ground, and at one particular stage in time, there were 500 horses working on the ground in his pit, there'd be a major inquiry, because manpower, they could get manpower, but horses, they couldn't get. Said earlier on, have been outstanding, and they would have wanted it that way then, that they've got their own autonomy, that they haven't got us interfering with them running the kitchens, etc. then, and it has worked, as far as we're concerned, in an excellent manner then.
Strike for 10 months, we've lost our money. Was you know what it about money? If we weren't about money, we wouldn't be working class. And 12 months ago, people had money to spend, so you didn't care about your next door neighbor then. But now you haven't got money, you are beginning to care about your next door neighbor. You're beginning to care about the community. And that's what we have got now. We've got a community now. And that's why we'll never lose.
What we want, what we are saying is that every child have got a right to say what he wants to do. But now, as it is now, they just chuck on the ash tip.
They haven't got
the opportunity to do nothing. This is what we are saying. That's our pride.
I came out of the Majesty's forces 7 years ago. Right? I was 43. And I had a job to get, a job in this valley. And the only place I could get it was the NCB. Right? And I'm fighting now so that people that follows me can take the same opportunity that I had. One opportunity. That's all I had. But I was too old for other firms at 43 years of age. So why should, you know, the youngsters that surround us by utterly, why should they suffer?
Yeah.
I think they had a Christmas to remember. Giving the toys out was the best. We worried ourselves sick. Oh, I hope everybody got the same. I hope we haven't offended anybody. I hope we haven't left anybody out, you know, that type of thing. Oh, and it went great.
We are fighting for the livelihood of our children. They will be able to look back on 1984 then and say that our parents fought for us.
I've done a 12-month of, well, everything in general, for the strike. I've been in front. I have never given in. I have never sat back. And I have never refused anybody. And I am very proud of it. And I'll be proud to look back on it.
We've had to fight for everything we got. Any agreement, any wages, any holidays, you name it, we've had to fight for it. There's nothing being given us on the plate.